right, time to go back in the film room presented by YouTube TV for week three with Daniel Jeremiah. And DJ, I don't think anybody envisioned Justin Herbert starting this game and playing as well as he did last Sunday against the Chiefs.
Yeah, well, look, it was a chaotic environment, right? When you find out you're starting right at the last minute, we didn't know up in the booth he was going to be starting. On the sidelines, there was a little commotion. And then he just got thrown out there. And all he did was march right down the field, lead the Chargers to an opening drive, touchdown, and really was able to function within the chaos throughout the entire game. And I want to show you three examples of that here, Chris. This first one here, this is going to be a play where the Chiefs bluff like they're blitzing. They're only going to rush four. They're going to drop seven. And the Chargers, look at all the blockers they're going to keep in here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven-man protection. They're only rushing four, but yet you end up getting a beat here against Hunter Henry off the edge. So you get that type of a beat. That's pressure coming right in the face of Justin Herbert, and he's got a lot of bodies to sort through down the field. But just look at this throw under pressure, and look how this ball is just over the top of Tyrann Mathieu and dropped right into the bucket. You cannot throw that football any better than that under pressure to Keenan Allen.
That looked like a seven-year vet just threading the needle. What's next here? Let's fire this up, YouTube TV.
Yeah, here we go here on this next one. Again, the theme is being able to function in chaos. You're going to get a blitz here. You're going to see, look, they're coming. They're coming off the slot. You're going to see inside blitz as well. They're bringing the house here. They're going to get an unblocked defender. Now, this is something Justin's going to get more comfortable of understanding where these hots are, and he's going to be able to see it a little bit quicker. But even though he doesn't see it right away, as you see the free rusher come off the edge, watch just the athleticism here. Okay, oh, I got a free rusher. Oh, just duck right underneath him. Keep my eyes down the field and locate Hunter Henry for a nice pickup here of 19 yards in the middle of the field. Again, just showing that composure and poise amidst the chaotic environment for a guy making his first start.
DJ, what I was so impressed with was the way he distributed the ball to a lot of different guys, from Keenan to Hunter to Austin to Josh Kelly.
Yeah, it just he opens things up. You know, he's able to hit other guys. He also opens things up because of his athleticism. He's so big. You know, he's such a big, strong guy. But then to be able to do this, to be in the red zone, to be able to run speed option like they do on this play right here, you're going to see the athleticism. This is what we saw at Oregon, too, once he's in the run game. He's going to pitch off the end. Once he sees the end settle, fake the pitch. He's got him beat. But watch Chris Jones, 95. He gets outside of this block and flashes. So instead of staying on his original path, he's going to actually read a block like a running back, cut inside him, and pick up some extra yards. And then watch where this contact is made right there. Now watch where he ends up because he's so big and strong. That's an extra 6-7 yards after he's contacted by a defender. And here you go. You've got first and goal at the 2-yard line. So his size, his athleticism, you know, we've seen the big throws down the field. But once you get in the red zone and some of these short yardage situations, that's really going to come into play for this offense.
All right, DJ, let's flip it over to Carolina. Another impressive rookie for the Panthers.
Yeah, they've got a big-time rookie in Jeremy Chinn, their second-round pick. And a lot of people thought in the first round they might take Isaiah Simmons out of Clemson, who's kind of a hybrid defender, can play some safety, some linebacker, really, really explosive. They decided to go with the defensive lineman and Derek Brown instead, and they circled back for Jeremy Chinn. And so far through a couple games, Jeremy Chinn's actually outplayed Isaiah Simmons. And I want to show you a couple of plays here of what the Chargers are going to be looking at. And a guy like Austin Eckler is going to see a lot of Jeremy Chinn in this game. He's lined up on the Panther in here against the Raiders. And watch him. He's going to press the line of scrimmage. He's literally engaged with the right tackle right here. Look where he is engaged. And look, the ball is going to be a smoke screen out to the top. It's a smoke screen out to Bryan Edwards. And watch how fast he comes off this, sees it. Watch him close and then make the tackle. Jeez. I mean, that is he has got big-time speed. He ran 4.45, I should say, at the combine, and you can see that 4.45 speed in a big way to watch him chase laterally. And then I'll just give you one more example of what he can do. Here he is. He's lined up. It looks like it could be Gronk out there in the slot. No, it's, you got a couple tight ends out there. Watch him duck underneath this block. That is Gronk. He's going to duck right underneath him on this little swing to the back and come to balance and make a secure tackle on the edge. So we've seen the Chargers in this offense be able to get the ball out to Keenan Allen on some of these smoke screens. We've seen Austin Eckler and Joshua Kelly get involved in the passing game. It's going to create a lot of one-on-one opportunities within space with Jeremy Chinn, and those are going to be opportunities the Chargers need to win. It's not going to be an easy task because this rookie is darn good.
DJ, is he living up to what you saw on tape going into the draft?
Yeah, Southern Illinois, man. You did not – when I flipped on the tape the first time, I was blown away, and he's brought it so far in his NFL career.